What's going on, everybody? My name is Jake, and today I'll be reviewing the GT Racing Chair Blue. It's the GT002 edition, the blue edition, and I'm also going to build it.
Okay, guys, so the packaging on this assembly kit is actually really nice. It's really well organized, and they give you everything you need to put it together. One person can do it by themselves. I've done it already twice now, and it's gone really good both times. So I'm going to tell you exactly what you're going to need to do step by step. That way you don't have any trouble with it if you decide to get this chair. And the video will help you as well. And so to get these two first pieces in together, you're going to need four of the M825 pieces. Four of those screws. They're the longer screws of the kit. And you'll go ahead and line them up with the holes and get them threaded in by hand just a little bit. That way you have it set there and it's not falling down or anything. So I got both of these on this first right side, and then I did the other side after and got those in. And so once you get them in by hand, you'll go ahead and get your wrench that they give you. It's the bigger one for the biggest screws. And you're going to go ahead and run them crisscross, because you want to make sure it squeezes in evenly. So I went top left, bottom right, bottom left, and then top right. Two times is what I did. I went across twice. And then I run them all the way up. They'll stop. They'll get tight. So that's what you want to do. And once you get that, I went ahead and put the plastic guards over the middle. And it's going to take two small pieces, the M510. It's actually two small screws. They're called the M510 inside this kit. And so you'll pop in the bottom piece. It's a little bottom round circle that snaps in. And then you'll run in that screw. That's only one hole, so you can't miss it. And once you see how I'm doing on this side right here, you'll pop it in. And then you'll run the screw in. And then you'll go ahead and use your caps. Your cap covers on those two holes. Makes it look really nice. So for the base plate, it's going to take four screws. The M820. And you only have four pieces of this in the kit. So you can't get them confused. But it'll say front and front. So go ahead and match that up. And the same way like you did the backrest, you're gonna do them evenly. Crisscross. That way you suck it in evenly. Equal pressure, and it's not lopsided or anything. And you'll see how I do it here. So I did top right, bottom left, bottom right, top left. And then these will run up till they stop once you go to start tightening them. See how I'm doing right here? They stop, stops. You don't want to over tighten, but you want to make sure they're firm, because this is where you're sitting at. So once that's done, you'll go ahead and get the armrest up and going. And that's four screws on both sides for these. And this is the long ones, the rest of the M825s. And you'll do them crisscross evenly. And you can adjust them in or out. That's however you set the screws. But make sure they're tight, because this is probably the most critical part, because you lean on these. You're going to go ahead and lean on armrest a lot. So make sure they're tight and firm. So once you get those all screwed in, the armrest will actually have a left and a right. They'll have an L and an R on which side you need to put them. You'll see that once you unpackage them from the box. It'll be on the bottom metal part of the armrest. So here you're going to set the gas lift in. All right, once you pop in the wheels, you just push them right in. And then you'll set the gas lift in with the metal piece, shiny piece, sticking up. You'll place a cover, and you'll place it inside that hole and push it down, and it's ready to go. And then I'm going to go ahead and stop it right here. And so the best way to get the pillows on is to actually start with the base pillow, the back pillow, the bottom pillow. So take it out of the package and unclip both sides of the straps, and you're actually gonna slide the bottom pieces underneath the back of the bottom, between the bottom and the back of the chair, just like I'm doing. It's not too hard. You just slide it right in between the chair, and then you'll go ahead and stretch them up towards the holes. And then you'll pull the top part of it through the holes, and you'll clasp it together, and that's how you set the bottom or the back pillow on the chair. Yeah, right through the holes, and then we'll go ahead and match them up and pull it and clasp it. Got the left one clasped already, and you'll clasp the other one, and then once you get that done, you'll be ready for the headrest. Takes a little bit of effort. You gotta stretch it over and then click it, but it's done. See, and that sits really nicely. The headrest is really easy. You just loop it through the middle piece of those two holes and clasp it together, and it's done. So the really cool part about this chair is it's actually really comfortable, really firm, really solid, and it's also aesthetically really cool. The armrests actually raise and lower, as you'll see that I'll demonstrate. And one of the coolest features of this chair is that you can actually lean all the way back in it like you're actually going to sleep, and it won't flip over as long as you don't lean too far, of course. But the base is really big, but you can lean really far back, you'll see here in a second. Depending on your height, you can adjust it, but it's super comfortable and it looks sick. So you'll pull on the right hand lever to lean back, and you can adjust it to however you want when you're sitting on your computer or whatever you decide to use your chair for. See, that's a pretty comfortable position right there, but you can go even further if you want. That's pretty far back. I mean, sleep in there if you want. And so that's pretty much the basics of the chair, and I hope you like it. And I'll drop the link in the description. And I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Thanks. Well guys, if you enjoyed the video, please like and subscribe. I'm going to drop the link where you can buy this chair, this very chair, the blue one or the red one, in the link in the description below. And if you got any questions on setting up your chair or need help with it, please contact me, comment, and I'll get back to you. Thanks for watching.